Hello and thanks for joining us. This is the Signature TV 30 Minutes. I am Obomanu Marvelous Chinedu. In the headlines, stakeholders meet in Abuja on new plans to tackle human smuggling in Nigeria. Oyo State government floods Ibarapa Oko-Ogun with 200 Amotekun officers to address influx of Fulani herdsmen. Speaker of the House of Representatives says petroleum industry bill will be passed by April 2021. And now the details. Stakeholders in the global fight against smuggling of migrants and trafficking in persons converged in Abuja on Wednesday to seek new collaboration to tackle the challenge. The meeting initiated by the Nigerian Immigration Service attracted the United Nations, the United States Embassy in Nigeria, the Swiss Embassy, and law enforcement agencies in Nigeria. Signature TV correspondent Chibueze Obi covered the meeting and filed in this report.
The United Nations, the US, and Swiss governments have thrown their weight behind Nigeria's drive to curtail the activities of smugglers and traffickers in migrants. At a stakeholders meeting organized by the Nigerian Immigration Service and the National Agency for the Prohibition of Trafficking in Persons, NAPTIP, in Abuja on Wednesday, the UN and the ambassadors of US and Switzerland promised to collaborate with Nigeria in addressing the challenge.
NIS, with NIS we have a long and excellent relationship. We signed together working arrangements for the mutual cooperation and the standard operational procedure for the deployment of two officers of NIS.
To support all efforts to eliminate trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants in Nigeria, we must collectively support the ability to gather and analyze reliable data, ensure evidence-based and coordinated response, develop targeted communication tools, strengthen governance of migration for safe, orderly, and regular migration, enhance the provision of accurate and timely information at all stages of migration, improve the migration coordination mechanism at the national, state, and local government levels, and ensure the prosecution of national and international offenders complicit in human trafficking.
NAPTIP to see a renewed commitment to collaboration, because if we're not standing as one team, the enemy wins and the enemy are the traffickers and people of Nigeria are the victims. So we're very excited about moving forward in a new lockstep.
The Comptroller General of Immigration, Mohammed Babandede, had called for a partnership with international bodies and agencies within Nigeria to strengthen the fight against trafficking and smuggling of migrants in Nigeria.
Challenges to investigation. Interagency rivalry. Unwillingness of sister law enforcement agencies to cooperate.
It's partnership in combating smuggling of migrant and trafficking in person. This is key. In this conference, we agree before we leave this partnership, we need to highlight to government that there has to be a platform. I'm not a person who organized, who believes in many agencies to be established, but there has to be a tool. There has to be a capacity. There has to be a forum. There has to be a legislation to tackle organized crime.
The Comptroller General called for shared intelligence and technical partnership with NAPTIP and the Nigerian Immigration Service, as well as other agencies such as law enforcement agencies, the labor union, and information technology companies to eradicate the smuggling of migrants in Nigeria. The Director General of NAPTIP, Josiah Emerole, said that his agency would work in partnership with the Immigration Service to combat the challenge. He lamented the slow judicial process, inadequate funding, and the carefree attitude of law enforcement agencies to the challenge of the trafficking and smuggling of migrants. Obi Chibueze, Signature TV News, Abuja.
The police command in Anambra said it has uncovered a baby factory where young girls are being impregnated and their babies sold by human traffickers. Chief Superintendent of Police Haruna Muhammad, the command's public relations officer, who disclosed this in a statement on Wednesday in Awka, said 10 suspects were arrested and 5 newborn babies rescued. According to him, three other children have been rescued in a coordinated raid led by Assistant Commissioner of Police Afolabi Wilfred, Orifite Area Commander at Oba in Idemili South Local Government Area of the state. According to Mohammed, five of the suspects are pregnant. He said that the rescued children would be handed over to the Ministry of Social Welfare, Children and Women's Affairs for proper care. He added that efforts were being made to apprehend other accomplices in order to bring them to justice. The Oyo State Governor Seyi Makinde has announced the deployment of 200 officers of the Western Nigeria Security Network, codenamed Amotekun, to Ibarapa and Okogun zones. This is in the wake of the crisis in the area between local farmers and Fulani herdsmen accused of masterminding rape, murder, and kidnapping. The state government said on Wednesday that the two officers were deployed after a meeting with security agencies and stakeholders in Ibarapa land. The meeting was held with representatives of Igangan, Ibarapa land, the recently appointed Commissioner of Police Oyo State, Ngozi Onadeko, and other stakeholders. The governor said that the town hall meetings and community outreaches would hold in few weeks to enable residents and security officers to talk about issues of immediate concerns. President Muhammadu Buhari on Wednesday presided over the 31st Virtual Federal Executive Council meeting at the State House. The Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, and the Secretary to the Government of the Federation, Boss Mustafa, were physically in attendance. Before the meeting, the council observed a minute silence for three former ministers, Dauda Brima, Muhammadu Gambo Jimeta, and Abdullahi Ibrahim, who had passed away. Dauda Brima, who served as the Minister of Education from 1997 to 1998, died on the 5th of January 2021 at the age of 80. Muhammadu Gambo Jimeta died on the 21st January at the age of 83. He was the Minister of Agriculture from 1995 to 1997. Abdullahi Ibrahim was Minister of Education, Science and Technology, as well as Transport and Aviation between 1984 and 1985. The Ondo State All Progressives Congress, APC, has suspended a governorship aspirant, Jumoke Anifowose, with immediate effect. The spokesperson of the party in the state, Alex Kalejaye, confirmed her suspension to newsmen on Wednesday. Her suspension was contained in a letter signed by 25 out of the 29 officers of the party at a meeting in Iboroko Unit 1, Ward 2, Owo Local Government Area of the state. She was said to have been suspended for alleged anti-party activities and for not making any contribution to the development of the party. Also stated that she has not been attending party meetings in the last 4 years. Anifowose, who was a governorship aspirant in the last election in Edo State, is also the daughter of the first civilian governor of the state, Chief Adekunle Ajasin. The governor of the Borno State, Babagana Zulum, has hailed the outgoing service chiefs for their contributions to the development of the country. Governor Zulum on Tuesday noted that the service chiefs helped in the fight against insurgency and acknowledge their efforts in the growth of the nation at large. The governor said he looks forward to working with the new appointees, particularly the Chief of Defence Staff, General Lucky Irabo, and the Chief of Army Staff, Major General Atahiru, who both served as theatre commanders in Borno State. The Borno State Governor Samuel Otom has tested positive for COVID-19. A statement by his Chief Press Secretary Tava Akase on Wednesday says the governor's result turned positive after a close aide also returned positive in the last few weeks. He noted that the governor did not show any symptoms of the disease but has already commenced treatment as prescribed by medical personnel. Akase called on those who came in contact with the governor to go for a COVID-19 test and ascertain their status. The close aides to the governor who have so far tested positive includes his orderly, his ADC, one of the DSS operatives attached to the governor, his private principal secretary, his senior special assistant on protocol, and the permanent secretary, Ministry of Finance. Governor Otem urged Benue people to continue to observe the protocol for the prevention of the virus, such as wearing face masks, use of hand sanitizers, and regular washing and physical distancing. He also encouraged residents of the state not to be afraid of going for the COVID-19 test, as only doing so would help in containing the spread of the disease. The pioneer Grand Cadi of the Kwara State Sharia Court of Appeal, Justice Abdul Kadri Orire, is dead. He died on Tuesday at the age of 87. In a condolence message, Kwara State Governor Abdurrahman Abdurrazak described the late jurist as an exemplary leader who has distinguished himself as an erudite legal scholar, researcher, Muslim community leader, and development activist. The governor also commiserated with the Emir of Elorin, Dr. Ibrahim Sulu Gambare, the Elorin Emirate Descendants Progressive Union, and the entire state on what he described as a sad but yet inevitable development. In the same vein, the Emir of Elorin and Chairman Kwara State Council of Chiefs, Ibrahim Sulu Gambare, described the deceased as a committed elder statesman who contributed immensely to the propagation of Islam. The late Orire was the Grand Cadi of the Kwara State Sharia Court of Appeal between 1975 and 1999. The Speaker of the House of Representatives, Femi Gbajabiamila, has said the long-awaited petroleum industry bill would be passed by the House by the month of April 2021. Gbajabiamila stated this on Wednesday at a public hearing on the bill co-hosted by the Speaker and the House Ad Hoc Committee on PIB, chaired by Representative Tahir Monguno. The bill seeks to provide for legal, governance, regulatory fiscal framework for the Nigerian petroleum industry and the development of host communities. On the 24th November 2020, the PIB was debated by the House. It passed second reading and was referred to the Ad Hoc Committee on the bill. On Wednesday, the House of Representatives welcomed stakeholders to a two-day public hearing on the PIB. And now to the stock market report. At the close of business on the floor of the Nigerian Stock Exchange on Wednesday, investors gained over 180.8 billion naira. The gain was driven by a rise in the prices of Ethiopian African PLC, MTN Nigeria, and other 33 companies. The equity capitalization rose from 21.753 trillion naira to 21.934 trillion, a 180.8 billion naira gain. The all share index consequently rose to 41,930.73 points from 41,584.94 points on Tuesday. The volume of shares traded was 543.597 million, valued at 7.321 billion naira. The bulls led the floor as there were 35 gainers against 21 losers. Guni Insurance PLC was the highest gainer, whilst Carvan led the losers. Zenibank shares was the most traded, trading 47.161 million shares, valued at 1.242 billion naira in 511 deals. And now in sports, Chelsea's new manager Thomas Tuchel has been told by the club management that he has to qualify the team for the Champions League in his first 6 months. Tuchel on Tuesday signed a 2.5-year contract to replace Blues legend Frank Lampard. However, the former Paris Saint-Germain brawls will not be given much time to settle at the Stamford Bridge. Tuchel will jump straight in at the deep end and take charge when Chelsea host Wolverhampton Wanderers in the Premier League on Wednesday. The German takes over with the Blues sitting 10th on the table with just 2 wins in their last 8 league games. Despite this, the board is expecting big things from him in the short term. According to reports, Tuchel has to ensure Chelsea finish in the top four or go on to win the Champions League so they return to the competition next season. The Blues face Atletico Madrid in the knockout stages next month. Before we end the news, the headlines again. Stakeholders meet in Abuja on new plans to tackle human smuggling in Nigeria. Oyo State government floods Ibarapa, Oke-Ogun with 200 Amotekun officers to address influx of Fulani herdsmen. Speaker of the House of Representatives says petroleum industry bill will be passed by April 2021. The second wave of COVID-19 is projected to go up at this time of the year. Please do well to stay safe, maintain physical and social distancing, and wear your face mask whilst going about your daily activities. That's the Signature TV 30 Minutes. On behalf of my producer, Damilola Abudu, I am Obomano Marvelous Chinedu. Thanks for watching.